அஸ்மத் குருபியோ நமகா, அஸ்மத் சர்வகுருபியோ நமகா, அஸ்மத் பரமகுருபியோ நமகா. ஸ்ரீமதே ஸ்ரீலக்ஷ்மி நரசிம்ம பரபிரம்மணே நமகா. ஸ்ரீமதே சிவன் சடகோ பஸ்தி வேதாந்த தேசியரீந்திர மகா தேசிகாய நமகா. ஸ்ரீமதே ஸ்ரீலக்ஷ்மீ நரசிம்ம திவ்ய பாதுகா சேவக சிவன் சடகோப ஸ்ரீ நாராயண எதீந்திர மகா தேசிகாய நமகா. ஸ்ரீமதே சிவன் சடகோப ஸ்ரீ ரங்கநாத எதீந்திர மகா தேசிகாய நமகா. ஸ்ரீமான் வெங்கடநாதாரிய கவிதார்க்கிக கேசரி வேதாந்தாச்சாரிய வரியோ மே சன்னிதத்தாம் சதா கிருதி ஞானானந்தமயம் தேவம் நிர்மலஸ்படிகாகிருதிம் ஆதாரம் சர்வ வித்யானாம் ஹயக்ரீவம் உபாஸ்மஹே. வந்தே பிருந்தாவனச்சரம் வல்லவி ஜனவல்லவம் ஜயந்தி சம்பவம் தாமவை ஜயந்தி விபூஷணம் ஜன்மாத்யஸ்ய யதோன்வயாதித்தரத சார்தேஷ்வபிஜ்ஞஸ்வராட் தேனே பிரம்மஹதாயாதி கவயே முஹ்யந்தி யத் சூரயஹ தேஜோ வாரிமிருதாம் யதா விநிமயோ யத்ர த்ரஸர்கோ மிருஷா தாம்னா ஸ்வேன சதா நிரஸ்த குஹகம் சத்யம் பரம் தீமஹி தர்ம ப்ரோஜித கதைவோத்ர பரமோ நிர்மத்சராணாம் சதா வேத்யம் வாஸ்தவமத்ர வஸ்து சிவதம் தாபத்ரயோன்மூலனம் ஸ்ரீமத் பாகவதே மகாமுனி கிருதே கிம்பா பரைரீஸ்வரஹ சத்யோ ஹ்ருத்ய வருத்ய தேத்ர கதிபிகி சிஸ்ரூஷுபித்த தக்ஷணாத் நிகம கல்பதரோர்கழிதம் பலம் சுகமுகாத் அமுர்தத்ரவ சம்யுதம் பிபத பாகவதம் ரசமாலயம் முகுரகோ ரசிகா புவி பாவுகா யம் ப்ரௌரஜன்ன மனுவேதமவேத கிருத்யம் தொய்பாயனோ விரககாதர ஆஜுஹாவ புத்ரேதி தன்மயதயா தரவோபினேது தம் சர்வபூதஹதயம் முனிமானதோஸ்மி நாராயணம் நமஸ்கிருத்யம் நரஞ்சைவ நரோத்தமம் தேவீம் சரஸ்வதீம் வியாசம் ததோ ஜயமுதிரயே கிருஷ்ணாய வாசுதேவாய தேவகி நந்தனாய ச நந்தகோபகுமாராய கோவிந்தாய நமோ நமஹ. நம பங்கஜநாபாய நம பங்கஜமாலினே நம பங்கஜநேத்ராய நமஸ்தே பங்கஜாங்கிரயே. வேதத்தை வேதத்தின் சுவைப்பயனை விழுமிய முனிவர்கள் விழுங்கும் கோதலின் கனியை நந்தனார்களிற்றை குவலையத்தோர் தொழுதேத்தும் ஆதியை அமுதை என்னை ஆளுடை அப்பனை ஒப்பவரெல்லா மாதர்கள் வாழும் மாடமாமையிலை திருவல்லிக்கே நிகண்டேனே. வசுதேவ சுதம் தேவம் கம்சசானூரமர்தனம் தேவகி பரமானந்தம் கிருஷ்ணம் வந்தே ஜகத்குரும் சாந்திரானந்தாவபோதாத்மகம் அனுபமிதம் காலதேசாவதிப்யாம் நிர்முக்தம் நித்யமுக்தம் நிகம சதசகஸ்ரேண நிர்பாஸ்யமானம் அஸ்பஷ்டம் திஷ்டமாத்ரே புனரரு புருஷார்த்தாத்மகம் ப்ரஹ்மதத்வம் தத்தாவத்பாரி சாக்ஷாத் குரு பவனபுரே அந்த பாக்கியம் ஜனானாம். தொட்ட படையட்டும் தோலாத வென்றியான் அட்டபுயகரத்தான் அங்கியான்று குட்டத்து கோள் முதலை துஞ்ச குறித்தெரிந்த சக்கரத்தான் தாழ் முதலே நங்கட்கு சார்வு நாராயணா ஓ மணிவண்ணா நாகனையாய் வாராய நாரிடை தீக்காய் வி ஆர் லுக்கிங் அட் தி கஜேந்திர மோக்ஷம் அண்ட் டுடே இஸ் தி 14th லெக்சர். யூஸ்வலி இந்த கஜேந்திர மோக்ஷம் மெனி ஆஃப் தி உபன்யாசம் இஸ் அபவுட் தி டிஸ்கிரிப்ஷன் அபவுட் தி ஸ்டோரி how Gajendra cut into the clutches of the crocodile. They explain all of them. And what was the previous story? How come they got the shabam and they come into a crocodile and to the elephant and everything? But very rarely people go through the slogans, what Gajendra's, what do you call, outcry, outpouring of that one, because he was caught by the crocodile for 1,000 years. First 500 years he called everybody to help, nobody helped. Second 500 years he tried to get out by himself, that also doesn't help. Then he really understands, exactly similar to Uddhava Gita, first slogan says, Tvam tu sarvam parityajya sneham swajana bandhushu. Similar to that one, he understands none of them can help. This comes in Bhagavadam in the 8th skandam. It comes in the Bhagavadam in the 8th skandam, 3rd adhyayam. Gajendra Moksham is 28 slokas. And what we are doing, very creative way of audience explanation of that one. It is not written in any Vyakhyanam. So if people find anything offensive or people find anything wrong, just only anubhavam only. So what I am making this one, how each of the sloka connects to the Upanishad, Bhagavad Gita, Sri Bhashyam and everything. And that is what the words they have used. So it is so interesting to explore all of them, and I am enjoying this one while we are telling this class. I am also enjoying, and make other people also to see all those things. Last class we saw, I will make it in a very short one. Namo Shantaya Ghoraya Moodaya Gunadharmine Nirvisheshaya Samyaya Namo Jnana Ganaya Cha. Amazing sloka. Until that was a 12th sloka. Until the 11th sloka, what Gajendra was trying to do, Bhagavan's Surubam, Bhagavan's Gunam, it was mesmerized in that one and he was calling. Now he understood, even though Bhagavan Atma Surubam is so great, Shubham, but Ashrika Desigan says, Imbaraman in Divyatma Surubam, Subame Agayilum, Ashrika Aridhagayale. We have two things. One, Embaraman Divya Atma Surubam. Like Parasara Magarishi sa Jodim Si Vishnugu, Bhavanani Vishnugu, Jalani Vishnu, everything you can see as Perumal. But we don't have that kind of a mentality. So we need a structure, we need an idol, we need some form, so we can touch, we can talk, we can do prayers and everything. That is why Embaramanin Divya Mangala Vigraham Subamayum Ashraika Sulabamayum Irkum. Very simple, when you go and do the Prabhati, the Acharyan does not do in front of the forest. You see the Perumal everywhere, let's do the Prabhati. No, he has got a Vigraham there. Because you can concentrate on that one. So when you do the Sharanagari, Ashraya, Ashrayam means you do the refuge. You give yourself to the Bhagavan, total unconditional surrender. So you do that before the Divya Mangala Vigraham. That is both Shubham and also easy to hold on to that. So that is why this Gajendra, first 11 slogas, it tried Perumal Divya Atma Surubham. I made a mistake. Now I had to go to the Divya Mangala Vigraham. Where can evil go? Divya Mangala Vigraham. Because crocodile was holding. So he can think of Lord Rama, Krishna and all of the avatarams. So Param and Vyugam, and it comes to the Vibhava Avataram. So that is why Ramayanam and Mahabharatam and everything, Bhagavad Gita is there for us to keep on enjoying that one. And that is a tool with which we correct ourselves, we understand our Siddhantam, and then go and do Sharanagari and go to Moksha. So that is why this Gajendran saw that one, and we saw beautifully Swaroopa, Roopa, Guna, Vibhuti. So Swaroopam is innate nature, Roopam is a form, shape and beauty and everything. Guna is a noble characters, Vibhuti is the Lord's ownership, Lordship. So here it understood the Divyatma Swaroopam was tough, and then it moved into the Vibhavavataram. There are 7 words. Shantaya, Ghoraya, Moodaya, Gunadharmine, Nirvisheshaya, Samyaya, Jnanaganaya. Amazing words. If you look at each one of them, and then I try to be, put it creatively, this, all the 7 refers to the 10 avatarams. We saw all the details and everything. I don't want to go back again into that. So now we move to the 13th sloka. The 13th sloka is an amazing one of all of them. This is the one really explains Visishtadvaitam. If you look at Bhagavad Gita, Krishna in chapter 13 is explaining about the body and soul connection. Same thing Gajendran, instead of 13th adhyayam, 13th sloka is telling the same thing. So we shouldn't say 13 is a very unlucky number. It's not here. Because Krishna is explaining the body-soul relation there. Amazing sloka, where first what we do is just like all other classes, we look at the words, we look at the anyapadesham, external meaning, and then we go into the swapadesham. It will take a little while, probably we might finish. If it is not, we'll finish in the next class. Kshetra, kshetrajnaya, namastubhyam, sarva adyakshayaya, sakshini, purushaya, atma moolaya, moola prakritaye namaha. Kshetra, jnaya, jnaya means jnanam, that is what it says. Namastubhyam sarva adyakshaya, adyakshaya. These are all very tough words, but we'll find it. Sakshini, purushaya, atma moolaya, moola prakritaye namaha. Let's break each of the words so it's not that complicated. Kshetra Nyaya. Kshetram, if you look at that word, it is called place, region, area, domain, form, field, everything is a kshetram. We call Divya Kshetram, that means it's a divine place. And we hear commonly people go to the Tirtha Yatra and Kshetradanam. So that means a kshetram is a divine place in that context. So, jnanam jnaya. Jnaya in there means to be known, to be understood, learned, ascertained. That is called jnaya. Investigated, perceived, inquired upon. All of them is jnanam. What basically we are saying, knowing the knowledge about a place. That is what it means. Kshetra jnaya. One has to have the knowledge of the kshetram, that is what it says. What is the kshetram here? We are not talking about a place, we are not talking about a domain. The atma is going to have the knowledge. You know that one, we have a body and a soul. And body does not have any knowledge. Body is achetanam. Only knowledge you are having the atma. And the atma has got two type of knowledge. One dharmi jnanam, which is inside of that atma, it always point itself. Me, 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 me and everything. Because that atma, even in your sleep, it knows who you are. The atma will never do anything damage to itself. So all those kinds of things are coming from ragasatra saram, dharmi jnanam. Depending upon what kind of punya pavangal you have done, based on the karma, Bhagavan gives you janma here. And that janma, it is associated with the dharma bodha jnanam, which is an attribute. So dharma bodha jnanam is there for everybody, including muktas, including nityas, including Bhagavan. But for them, it is fully vikasam. Nothing is stopping them. So they can see everything. For us, based on whatever we have done, it is somewhat clobbered. That is why whether we like halwa, whether we like pavaka, or whether you are a very smart student, or whether you are not that smart, all the things are basically coming based on the dharma bodha jnanam. So to tell it very simplistically, is it prarabdha karma? Prarabdha karma comes into this dharma bodha jnanam. Okay, we understand that. So when we say kshetra jnaya, means only the atma has got the jnanam. Atma, where does it sit? It sits in the body. So the body is the kshetram and the atma is the owner inside there. That's what it means. Body and soul, shariram and atma. That is what we are looking. We call this is a sharira shariri bhavam. And Bhagavan is the soul. Jivatma and prakriti can be the body for him. You are the soul inside. The body is for you. So this is what we're going to be explaining, how you are connected to your body. Similarly, your body and your Atma is connected to the Lord. That is what the whole thing Gajendran is going to explain. Bhagavan is called Shariri and Jivatma and Achetanams are called Shariram. And he is called Dehi. All these things called Deham. I want to emphasize this Dehi because when you come to the next week to the Sri Bhashyam class, there we see Shrestha, Degi, Sonishta, those things will come from Nirvadi Mahima. Everybody memorized already. Adigana Saravali slogan will be coming. And that one Dehi, Bhagavan is the Dehi, he is the Atma inside, everything is the body for him. Okay, that is what Chetrajnaya. So we can, Chetrajnaya, we can say your Atma knows about the Chetram. Or Bhagavan, he knows about everything. Either one we can assume. Atma Moolaya. Moolam means origin, root, source, base. Everything is Moolam. Atma Moolaya. For all the Atmas, he is the origin. He is the base. That is what. Beautiful. Adi Moolam he does not call. Adi Bijam he calls. And Atma Moolam he calls. So people combine those two. Not even one sloka it says Adi Moolam. We say that Adi Moolame because it looks easier. That's why we tell Adi Bijaya Atma Moolaya. That's what he calls. So here Atma Moolaya means for all the Atmas is the root or origin or a support or a base for all of them. Next one, Moola Pragrdaye. Same Moolam he says that one for Pragrdi. When you look here in the Leela Vibhuti, what do you see? There are only two things we see. One your Atma, the other one is Prakriti. That's it. And another one we cannot evaluate, we cannot feel, that is called Kalam, time. Okay? So, Chetanas, if you take three types, Baddha Jeevan, Mukta Jeevan, Nitya Jeevan. Muktas, they went to the Moksha, not here. Nityas, they are always there. Only Baddha Jeevas, Baddha means bounded. We are all bounded souls, that is the souls are here. And what do you have? The body. What do you have? All the table and house and everything, they are all Achetanam. How the Achetanams are coming? It all mixed with Panchabhudangal. What is the origin for all of them? You go into the Prakriti. Prakriti, Mahattu, Agangaram, Panchatanmatrai, and then Panchabhudangal, Panja Karmendriyangal, Panja Nanendriyam, and then Manasu, and then Jivatma and Paramatma. You got 26 Tattvams. So that is how it's all classified and everything. So what do you have other than you? There are only three Achetanams are there. What are the three Achetanams? Suddha Sattvam, Prakriti and Kalam. Suddha Sattvam is always in Moksham. And not only in Moksham but also Bhagavan's Vigraham, Bhagavan's Thirumeni, everything is Suddha Sattvam. So on the Leela Vibhuti, what do you see? Only two things Achetanam. One is a Prakriti, the other one is a Kalam and then Jivatma. Those are all the only things you would be seeing. So here it says, Atma Moolaya, all the Atmas are covered. Moola Prakriteye, the Prakriti is covered over here. So all the Achetanam and Chetanam, what you see on the Leela Vibhuti is covered by these two words. Atma Moolaya, Moola Prakriteye. Next one it says, Sarva Adhyakshaya. Adhyakshaya, Adhyakshaya means a president, supervisor, superintendent, manager, director, administrator, controller, overseer, head, governor, boss. These are all taken from the dictionary. From the Nigandu, what it means, this Adhyakshaya, all these things. Because I want to say that one because it's very important. Later on we come to the principle, everybody knows, supports, controls, owns. That is why we are looking at that one. Sakshine. Sakshine means a Paramatma is looking at everything as an Antaryami. You don't see him, but he sees everything. Okay, that is why he's a Sakshi. Purushaya Tubhyam Namo Namaha. See, until 10th sloka, he was just saying Namaha, Namaha. Nothing happened. Then he started saying Namo Namaha, Namo Namaha. He added that. Remember, the more and more you say Namaha, it is coming from Gita Bhashyam. More and more Nama, 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 if you keep on saying, your problems will go away, your sins. The more sins go away, your atma will be clear. If your atma is clear, you can do the karma yoga and jnana yoga. If you are eligible for karma yoga and jnana yoga, you can go for the bhakti and prabhakti. That is all it is. That is a namo namo vang manasadi bhumaye. Remember Alavanda slogan. That is why you put everything namo namaha, namo namaha. So, the same way Gajendran got intelligent, oh, I call for Perumal, is still testing me. So, namo namaha, that's what he says. Purushaya, everybody knows Purushan means Supreme Soul. He is only one Purushan, everything else is Stri. Stri Prayam, Idaram Jagadhi. Veda says, Tubhyam, to you, namo namaha. A Supreme Soul, highest man, to you, I am doing this. Namo namaha. Easy way of saying namaha means prostration. Namaha means vanakkam. People say that. And you say that on a namaskaram. But nama actually means you taken from the ashtakshram. It is the prabhati. Namaha means prabhati. That is what Swami Desigan says all the time. So, in the Anyabhadesam, not too much there. What it says, Kshetra Jnaya, somebody who understands the Kshetram, the body, that is the Atma. Sarva Adhyakshaya, Bhagavan knows everything and he is the superintendent, he is the controller. Sakshini, even though you don't see the Bhagavan, he is seeing everything. Purushaya, he is the highest soul. Atma Moolaya, for all the Atmas, he is the base and root. Moola Prakriti, for Prakriti, from which everything manifested, that is also he is the base. Namaha, Namo Namaha. That is what it is, the Anyabhadesam. Now let's go to the Swabhadesam. That's what it makes it very interesting. Anyabhadesam, not much there. It's easily you can break the words and everything. But when we are trying to derive the inner meaning, now Kshetra Jnaya, that word itself will take several hours to explain that one. Because so beautifully he puts that word. Krishna says in Bhagavad Gita, chapter 13, why we are interested, it is three shadgams, you know that, Bhagavad Gita. So Bhagavad Gita, first is six, the second six, and the third six. Approximately, first six is karma yogam, second six is jnana yogam, third six is the bhakti yogam. He does not talk about prabhati until he comes over there. But for all of you to understand, when we say bhakti yogam, prabhati is andargadam. Bhakti people cannot do anything without prabhati. With all the million angas are there, some of them they have to do prabhati. What we are doing as, this is the total thing. I am not interested in that any of them. This is the total standalone prabhati. Out of the 32 Brahma Vidyas what you have in bhakti, prabhati is one of them. But prabhati stands alone compared to all others because it does not expect any of the prerequisites. The prerequisites are like karma yogam and jnana yogam, what you need for bhakti yogam. We don't need any of them. And we know that prabhati and bhakti has got so many differences. One of them, bhakti yogam, you have to do all through your life. Not only in this janma, millions of janma you have to do. And every second you have to be thinking of Bhagavan. Here you don't have to. So we understand all of them. So Krishna is explaining in the 13th adhyayam, starting itself he says, hey, you have to understand the body and soul relation. So, kshetra, kshetrajna, vibhaga, yogam. That is what he says. Kshetra means sariram, deham, body. Kshetrajnan means atma or soul. Because the kshetrajnan has got the knowledge about the kshetram. So, sarira, atma, brahmam, that is what we are always having. The first one you have to understand from Ragasatra Saramya, say, your body and soul are different. Most of the things what we do only for body. And we are so mesmerized into that one and thinking that is the atma. So, start separating those two. That is what they are trying to say. Shariram, we all know, it is made of jadam, no knowledge. Vikaram, it is always changing. See, small baby is here. As the time grows, it grows bigger. As the time grows, it becomes very old and everything. So all vikaram, changes are happening. And asthiram. We know that one, it keeps on dying. So all the sariram, we know sariram has got no knowledge, vikaram, and it dies. But on the soul has got chaitanyam, it's got the knowledge. Soul does not have any vikaram. It is a very atomic and microscopic level, and it is sthiram, permanent and eternal. In the 13th chapter, Krishna shows, hey, this is the body, this is the soul. Understand the difference between those two. How Gajendra, with only two words he has used, kshetrajnaya, correctly he started with that one, because that is how the Bhagavad Gita explains. Let's look at the 13th sloka in Bhagavad Gita, what Bhagavan says. Sri Bhagavan uvacha, idam shariram kaundheyam, kshetramityabhidhiyade, edatyo vetitam prahuhu, kshetrajna idi tatvidaha. Sri Bhagavan uvacha, Krishna is saying, Kaundheya, Kundi's son, Arjuna, idam shariram, this body, he was showing that one. Remember that one. Mam egam sharanam braja, when he says, he touches his body. That is what Pililogacharya writes in Mumukshupadi, Tannudi Thirimeni Tutte Kanbitan, Perumal. Why? Because we do ashrayanam only to the body. It has to be Divya Mangala Vigraham. We cannot see the forest, we cannot see the Naimisharanyam, everything is an aranyam, I'm doing prabhati. We cannot do that, because our mind cannot hold on to that. So, Kaundeya idam shariram is pointing now to Arjuna. Idam shariram, this shariram what you have, kshetram idi abhidhiyade, is called as kshetram. Ya veti edadi, the one who understands that, tam kshetrajya idi, the one who understands this as the kshetram, is called kshetrajyan. Parahu tadvidaha, he says, I'm not telling, all the learned people are telling like that. So Krishna first starts in this adhyayam, understand the body is called kshetram, the owner inside the atma is there, is called kshetrajyan. But you have to understand, this atma can exercise only this shariram. My atma cannot do anything to your body. So we are all only particularly into that one. Your atma's power can go only into that terminal point. It cannot go anything beyond that. Arjuna, this body is called a kshetram. The one who understands this is called kshetrajyan. Body, soul, kshetram, kshetrajyan. Idam shariram. The atma is the one who sees the body. The body is here. Atma is the one who sees the body, who understands it. That is why he says, in there. Why he says, idam, for you. Your atma understands your body and everything. Your atma does not understand other people's body. That is why atma is the looker, body is the looked up item. So, kshetram, another thing is very beautiful. The words that Krishna used here, kshetra means form, field, that is also there. If your body is the field, there are some seeds are put into the form. What are all the seeds? Your actions. When you put the seeds into that one, you get the crop and the fruits coming out of that. That is your punyam and pavam. So the body does everything. So Krishna points out all of them, only the body does. Atma does not do any of them. Atma allows all of them. That is the problem. And Atma does not have that much power. I will tell you, give an example, immediately you will know. So Atma does not have that much power. Only the body does, all the indriyangal does that one. Kshetram is continuously disappearing also, another one. So if you take it from the form, body does a mistake, it goes through the palan. Body does a good thing, it gets the fruit of that one. So kshetram for a form is also good. Another one is called, kshetram is called continuously disappearing. That is why it is called Deham. Deham means it is keeps on going away. One other thing I want to point out, in the second chapter, Krishna beautifully brings up two things. Kadasu, Agadasu. These two words, remember that one. Shankara Bhashyam is different and Ramanuja Bhashyam is different, Gita Bhashyam. సో గదాసు మీన్స్ డయింగ్, అగదాసు మీన్స్ నాట్ డయింగ్. సో వాట్ శంకర వాస్ ఎక్స్ప్లెయినింగ్, విల్ గో త్రూ దిస్ శ్లోగా అగైన్ ఇన్ ది గీతా భాష్యం. గదాసు ఈ వసై పీపుల్ ఆర్ డెడ్, పీపుల్ ఆర్ నాట్ డెడ్, దిస్ ఇస్ వాట్ దే వుడ్ డూ, దట్ ఇస్ వాట్ ఇట్ సేస్. బట్ ఎంబెర్మాన్ ఆర్ కమ్ అండ్ ఎక్స్ప్లెయిన్, నో నో నో, దట్ ఈస్ నాట్ ది వే. గదాసు మీన్స్ డయింగ్, విచ్ విల్ డై, బాడీ. అగదాసు మీన్స్ డస్ నాట్ డై, విచ్ ఈస్ ది ఆత్మ. సో ది బాడీ అండ్ ది ఆత్మ, దట్ ఈస్ వాట్ ఈ సేస్. ది రీజన్ వై ఐ వాంట్ టు పాయింట్ అవుట్, వీ డోంట్ వాంట్ టు గో త్రూ ది శ్లోగా అండ్ ఎవ్రీథింగ్, బట్ గదాసు అగదాసు, దట్స్ హౌ ది శ్లోగా కమ్స్. ఫస్ట్ వన్ ఇస్ టోల్డ్ ఇస్ బాడీ, సెకండ్ వన్ ఇస్ ఆత్మ. ది సేమ్ వే కృష్ణ హ్యాండిల్స్ ఇన్ ది 7th చాప్టర్ ఆల్సో, ఫస్ట్ వన్ ఇస్ ది బాడీ అండ్ దెన్ సెకండ్ వన్ ఇస్ ది ఆత్మ. వాట్ ఈ సేస్ హియర్ ఇన్ ది ఫస్ట్ శ్లోగా అండ్ ది 13th చాప్టర్, ఇదం శరీరం కౌందేయ, ఫస్ట్ బాడీ, దెన్ ఓన్లీ ది ఆత్మ. నౌ టేక్ అ లుక్ అట్ వాట్ గజేంద్ర టెల్స్. క్షేత్ర న్యాయ, క్షేత్ర మీన్స్ బాడీ అండ్ ది నాలెడ్జ్ ఆఫ్ దట్ వన్ ఇస్ ది ఆత్మ. సేమ్ వే వాట్ భగవద్గీత సేస్, ఈవెన్ ది ఆర్డర్ ఇస్ నాట్ ఈవెన్ చేంజ్డ్. భగవాన్ కన్సిస్టెంట్లీ సెట్ 2nd అధ్యాయం, 7th అధ్యాయం అండ్ 13th అధ్యాయం. దిస్ ఇస్ వాట్ కృష్ణ సెట్. సో గజేంద్ర నోస్ వెన్ భగవాన్ ఫాలోస్ సర్టన్ ఆర్డర్ దర్ హ్యాస్ టు బి సంథింగ్ ఇంపార్టెంట్. దట్ ఇస్ వై ఇట్ ఫాలోస్ ది సేమ్ ఆర్డర్ హియర్ ఆల్సో. సో గజేంద్రన్ సేస్ క్షేత్రజ్ఞాయ నమస్తుభ్యం. క్షేత్ర, దట్ ఈస్ ది బాడీ, క్షేత్రజ్ఞాయ ఈ స్మార్ట్ గజేంద్ర ఈస్ బీన్ అండ్ ది క్లచెస్ ఆఫ్ ది క్రోకడైల్. I don't have that much time. I have to use the smart words. I cannot say kshetra, kshetrajnan separately in everything. With a single word, it says kshetrajnaya. Kshetrajnaya, kshetram is the body. The knowledge of that one, second part of that one says the atma. So that is why it is the atma. So within a single word, even though what Krishna said, all of them, he even shrunk that one in this word. What is kshetrajnaya? The one who understands the body. Who understands the body? Only the Atma understands the body. It is the concept of Atma is different from the Deham. Deha, Atma, Abhimanam. We call Deha, Atma, Brahma. First you have to get rid of that one. Atma is Visheshyam. Deham is the Visheshanam. Okay? So, and you know that Abhridak Siddhi. పిరిక్క ముడియాదే, ది కెనాట్ ఇన్సెపరబుల్. యాజ్ లాంగ్ యాజ్ యూ లివ్, యువర్ బాడీ అండ్ ది ఆత్మ కెనాట్ బి సెపరేటెడ్. ఈవెన్ దో దర్ ఆర్ సమ్ ప్లేసెస్ ఇన్ వేదాస్ దే సే డోంట్ వేకప్ పీపుల్ వైల్ దే ఆర్ స్లీపింగ్. ది రీజన్ వై దే సే దట్ వన్, ది ఆత్మ గోస్ అవుట్ అండ్ కమ్స్ బ్యాక్. సో ఇఫ్ యూ వేక్ దెమ్ వెరీ ఫాస్ట్, ఆత్మ కెనాట్ ఎంటర్ దే. సి వేదాస్ అండ్ ఉపనిషత్ అండ్ ఇతిహాసం పురాణం, దే టెల్ సో మెనీ డిఫరెంట్ థింగ్స్. And many places it are exactly opposite. So we have to reconcile a lot of them. So we are not taking that one here. That is why Embermana is so great, how he reconciles everything, all the opposite things. So, Deha Atma Abhimanam. First you have to understand, Kshetra Jnaya. Why he says that one? Because in the Sunishta Vijnana Adhikaram, in Ragasyatra Saram, what we have done? Swaroopa Nishtai, Ubhaya Nishtai, Phalanishtai, we need that. If you go and stand before the mirror, it shows you who you are. But if you are a Prabhannan, how do you understand how good we are? We need a mirror. So the mirror, that one he shows. Sunishta Vijnanadhikaram, Swaroopa Nishtai. Swaroopa Nishtai, what it says? If somebody says anything about your body, hey, you don't have no hair, your eye is crooked, your ear is twisted. If somebody says, it does not belong to you. If somebody says, on the other hand, you have done so much pavam. Pavam goes to who? Only to the Atma. Then you have to worry about it. He is referring to me. When you say you, you, you means it is always the Atma. That's what we have to think, not the body. So don't worry about the body if anybody says. Same way, if somebody praises you, they say and says, the first thing that puts you down is the praise. Think, if somebody puts a fire while you are alive, that fire is the praise. If somebody gives you the praise about that one, everybody will have the ego in their head. So if somebody says anything about you, get out of that place. Otherwise you will get that ego. Only Perumal likes that. ఈస్ డిఫరెంట్. స్తుతిప్రియ, హీ కెన్ డూ ఎనీథింగ్ హీ వాంట్స్, బట్ వీ షుడ్ నాట్ బి ఇన్ టు దట్ వన్. దట్స్ వాట్ ది ఆచార్య షోస్ ఓవర్ హియర్. సో ఇన్ ది సునిష్ఠ అభిజ్ఞానాధికారం ఇట్ సేస్, ఎనీబడి సేస్ అబౌట్ ది బాడీ డోంట్ కేర్, ఎనీబడి సేస్ అబౌట్ ఆత్మ దెన్ యూ గో ఇమ్మీడియట్లీ అపరాధ సహస్ర భాజనం పదిదం బిబవన్నవోదరే అగదిం శరణాగదం హరే కృపయా కేవలం ఆత్మ సాద్గురు స్తోత్రరత్నం శ్లోకం. యూ గో టు ది పెరుమాళ్ అండ్ సే ఐ హవ్ డన్ మై సిన్స్ ఆర్ లైక్ ఓషన్, సో యూ ఆస్క్ ఫర్ ది అపరాధ క్షమాపణం. దట్స్ వాట్ ఈ సేస్. సో టేక్ అదర్ కాంటెక్స్ట్. వై వి సే ది బాడీ ఫస్ట్, గో బ్యాక్ టు ఉద్ధవ గీత. ఇన్ ది ఉద్ధవ గీత 24 గురుస్ అవధూదా ఇస్ సేయింగ్ all of them. So when it comes at the end, he says, I'm going to give you a baker's dozen, one extra. So the one extra is the 25th guru. Out of all of them, the most important guru, 25th guru, is your own body. You see your body and still you are thinking like this. And one place in Veda it says, your body does not belong to you. Your body belongs only to any of the three people. First one, fire. That's where it goes finally. Second one, earth. That's where it goes. Third one, to the birds. These are the only three. So Avadhuta says at that time, the reason why I'm jumping and doing all of them, because I find this body is not mine. If you have that one, we cannot do that. That is the problem we have. The problem we have, separating the body and the soul. It is a very, very, very hard. Even the rishis cannot do that one. So that is what Deshika was trying to say. Nobody is asking for a perfection. Okay? Sri Bhasham, when we go, we'll talk about Anandam Brahmano Vidvan. Anandam means, Swami Perumal has got more Anandam and less Dukkam. If you ask, no, it does not mean like that. Anandam means he's got more Anandam than you. That's all it means. So relative to all the Jeevans, he has got the more Anandam. Okay? Jeevan Swarupam is Jnanam, Bhagavan Swarupam is Anandam. That is what we are trying to say. Bhagavan also has got a Dukkam. He could not get rid of that. Why Dukkam is? All the souls are not coming. I'm trying all of them. They are not coming. He could have changed immediately. I cannot change. Because Shastra says like that. Even he has got handcuffed like that one. So Bhagavan also has got some of them. So what it says, Anandam means he has got more. So similarly, when I say here, separating the body and soul, it is very, very hard. All you can do is practice up to a certain level. There is no perfection here. Krishna says, Devi Yesha Gunamayi, Mama Maya Duratyaya, Mameye Prabhatyan, Maya Medam Tarantime. So he says that this Prakriti I created, you will never be a perfect person. That's what he says. We can try, but if you are a perfect person, if he says, that means Krishna's design is flawed. That's why what I'm saying is, don't get discouraged whether you are eating 2 halvas, 3 jalebis, or you sleep until 8 o'clock, you want all these kinds of things. The body needs that one. There's nothing wrong with that. But try to go into that one. That's what it says over here. So, the next one, Kshetrajnaya, we are thinking, I am the proprietor, I am the boss. You are not the boss. There is somebody is a boss above you. Even though you are an Atma and the Shariram you have, there is a bigger proprietor there. That is what we have to understand in the Sarira Sariri Bhavam. So, the Sarira Sariri Bhavam, what he says, coming into the next sloka, Krishna says, Kshetrajnam Chabhimam Vidhi Sarva Kshetreshu Bharada Kshetra Kshetrajyor Jnanam Yattajnanam Madam Mama. What is my religion? I don't care about what you are saying. My religion is one who understands the Kshetram and Kshetrajnam. And let's see how we explain that one. Kshetrajnam cha abhi mam viddhi sarva kshetreshu bharada. Bharada is Arjuna. Okay? Bharada viddhi. Hey Arjuna, understand this. Sarva kshetreshu. Understand in all the shariram. okay? Kshetragyam, okay? Kshetragyam is this Jivatma, because you are the Kshetragyan for each, for all the Sariram, there is a Jivatma, Kshetragyam. Cha and Abhi. This Abhi word is how you interpret that one. This is coming from Gita Bhashyam. Trikalam Swami so beautifully explains this one. This Abhi, what Sankara Bhashyam and what, see the words they put it here, Sanskrit in such a way, you can interpret any which way you want. But we have to find out general consensus with so many other things and see what it is. Okay? So, let's say if your spouse is there and 10 days you call, hi sweetheart. One day you got mad, you got something else. So, what is she? You cannot pick that one because the general consensus, you look at all of them, what is the context on which you do, and this is what the right one. That is how. Even though one or two says something different, that's okay. But that is how. We cannot have a perfect one. That's what Embermann are showing. So, based on all the context sensitiveness, that is what it is. Unless you could do with the context sensitive, you will end up with the wrong meanings. So, Abhi. Abhi means, in general, even though, also kind of a thing. But here, Embermanar explains this, Abhi means Shariram. In all the bodies, Jeevan and Shariram. Ma means, I am the Atma for all of them. The second sloka, first sloka Krishna says, Kshetram, Kshetragyan. Kshetram is the body, Kshetragyan is the knower. So we are all happy. So Krishna is telling about us. Second sloka he goes. No, it's not that one. All the Shariram is here. In all the Shariram, the Atmas are there. And the Shariram, each one of them, I am the boss. Mom, he says, Kshetragyam Cha Abhi. All the Jivatmas and their body. Okay, you got all of them. And then in front, Sarva Kshetreshu, in everything, the body and the Atma, I am the Atma there. Beautifully, Desian writes in the Ragasatra Saram, in the fourth chapter, he writes like that, Pradhana Pradidandaram. He writes, we're going to see in a moment, the sloka. Exactly what Krishna said in this 13th sloka, he does it in Tamil. We have to be very careful in saying, for all the Shariram you see, on all the Shariram, the Atmas inside and the Shariram put together, I am, Mom, I am the soul in all of them. So, that is what he says. You have to be very careful here how to explain all of them. Little more we are going here. Bhagavan is the Atma for Jagat and for the Jivatmas. Jagat, when you say that one, everything is included. Anything comes from the Prakriti. So, Panjabhudangal, all this table and the light and our body, everything is included on that. So, Jagat and Jivatma, Bhagavan is. So, that is what is used in Sri Bhashyam over there. Arjuna, in 11th chapter, he says, Sarvam samapnoshi tadosi sarvaha. Beautiful word. Sarvam samapnoshi tadosi sarvaha. Because you are present in everything, you are everything. Understand? Because you are pervaded everywhere, you are everything. What does it mean? Here, because Bhagavan is pervaded everything, can we call this table as the Bhagavan? That is where Embermanar are bringing one of them called Samanadigaranyam. Samanadigaranyam means the word that indicates the body can also be used to indicate the Atma. Okay? We find some kind of a commonality there. So, Samanadigaranya means relating to the same subject, being the same category, having a common substructure, same predicament. All these things are called Samanadigaranyam. So, Advaitam says, Aham Brahmasmi. You are the Brahma. Yeah, I am the Brahma. What is wrong with that? సో వి అక్సెప్ట్ దట్ వన్ బేస్డ్ ఆన్ సమానాధికరణ్యం. ఇట్స్ నాట్ రెఫరింగ్ టు యూ, ఇట్స్ నాట్ రెఫరింగ్ టు యువర్ ఆత్మ, బట్ ది భగవాన్ సిట్టింగ్ ఓవర్ దట్ దట్ ఈస్ ఎవ్రీవేర్. సో యు ఆర్ పార్ట్ ఆఫ్ హిమ్. ఆమ్ బ్రహ్మాస్మి, దట్ ఈస్ బేస్డ్ ఆన్ ది ఖడగ శృతి. సో వెన్ యూ సే సమానాధికరణ్యం, వాట్ ఇట్ మీన్స్ దర్ ఆర్ టూ థింగ్స్ ఆర్ హియర్, త్రీ పాసిబిలిటీస్. యూ కెన్ రెఫర్ టు ది బాడీ, యూ కెన్ రెఫర్ టు ది ఆత్మ, ఆర్ యూ కెన్ రెఫర్ టు బోత్ ఆఫ్ దమ్. సో మెనీ టైమ్స్ వెన్ దే రెఫర్ టు ది బాడీ, ఇట్ ఈస్ నాట్, యూ హ్యావ్ టు లుక్ అట్ ది కాంటెక్స్ట్, ఇట్ ఈస్ నాట్, ఇట్ ఈస్ రెఫరింగ్ టు ది ఆత్మ. మెనీ ప్లేసెస్ ఇన్ ఉద్ధవ గీత వి సీ ఆత్మ ఆత్మ ఇట్ విల్ సే, బట్ ఇట్ విల్ సే ఓన్లీ ది బాడీ. ఆర్ వెన్ ఇట్ సే ఆత్మ ఆత్మ, ఇట్ విల్ సే బోత్ ఆఫ్ దమ్. సో వీ హ్యావ్ టు ఫైండ్ ది కరెక్ట్ మీనింగ్ ఆఫ్ దట్ వన్. సో ఇన్ ది సమానాధికరణ్యం ఇస్ ఎ వెరీ ఇంపార్టెంట్ వన్. ట్రై టు ఫైండ్ ఇట్ అభేద శృతి సమ్ ఆఫ్ దమ్ దేర్, భేద శృతి సమ్ ఆఫ్ దమ్ దేర్, ది ఖడగ శృతి హౌ యూ జాయిన్ దమ్. ది ఖడగ శృతి భేద శృతి సేస్ దీస్ టూ ఆర్ డిఫరెంట్. అభేదం, దిస్ ఈస్ ది ఓన్లీ వన్. ఓకే, వాట్ వీఆర్ సేయింగ్, ఇట్ డిపెండ్స్ ఆన్ హౌ యూ లుక్ అట్ ఇట్. ఇఫ్ యూఆర్ బేస్డ్ ఆన్ ఆత్మ, దిస్ ఆత్మ ఈస్ డిఫరెంట్ ఫ్రమ్ దట్ ఆత్మ, యూ కెనాట్ బి ది సేమ్, బికాస్ అవర్ దర్శనం ఈస్ అభేదం. దట్ ఈస్ వాట్ తిరుకచ్చిన బిగల్ గాడ్ ఇట్ ఫ్రమ్ ది వరదాజ పెరుమాళ్. యూ టోల్డ్ ఆర్ వర్తై. సో ఇట్ ఈస్ అభేదం దోస్ టూ, బట్ బోత్ ఆఫ్ దెమ్ సేమ్, బికాస్ యూ కెనాట్ స్టే వితౌట్ హిమ్. యు ఆర్ ది పార్ట్ ఆఫ్ హిమ్, యు ఆర్ ది బాడీ. సో వెన్ యూ సే ద్వైతం చూడడం అది దట్స్ వాట్, బికాస్ జీవాత్మ అండ్ పరమాత్మ ఆర్ డిఫరెంట్, దర్ ఇస్ నో వే యూ కెన్ డూ. సో ఆన్ దట్ వే ఇఫ్ యూర్ లుకింగ్ అట్ దట్ ఈస్ భేదం, బట్ ఇట్ ఈస్ వన్ ఆఫ్ దమ్ అభేదం, బికాస్ యూ కెనాట్ ఎగ్జిస్ట్ వితౌట్ హిమ్, యు ఆర్ జస్ట్ ది బాడీ. సో వెన్ ఐ సే కెన్ యూ టేక్ ది సోల్ అవుట్ అండ్ గివ్ మీ ది సోల్ అండ్ ది బాడీ కెన్ మూవ్, ఇట్ కెనాట్. యాజ్ లాంగ్ అస్ యు ఆర్ అలైవ్, అబృదక్ సిద్ధి. అబృదక్ సిద్ధి మీన్స్ ఇట్ కెనాట్ బి సపరేటెడ్ ఎనీ టైమ్. వేర్ డు యూ సీ దిస్ అబృదక్ సిద్ధి? టూ ప్లేసెస్ యూ విల్ సీ. వన్ ఆఫ్ దమ్ ఇన్ ద్వయమంతరం, వాట్ యు సీ? శ్రీ మత్ నారాయణ. ది మత్ పదం సేస్ వన్ కెనాట్ లివ్ వితౌట్ ది అదర్, ఇట్స్ ఆల్వేస్ ఎటర్నలీ కనెక్టెడ్ టు ఈచ్ అదర్. వాట్ ఈస్ అదర్ ప్లేసెస్ యూ సీ దట్ వన్? అండ్ ఆల్ సేస్ ఉందన్నోడు ఉరవేల్ నమకింగు ఒళిక్క ఒళియాదు. ది ఉరవు, దట్ ఈస్ వాట్ ది హోల్ తిరుప్పావై ఇస్ ఎ సింగిల్ వర్డ్ కాల్డ్ ఉరవు. ది ఉరవు సేస్ యూ అండ్ భగవాన్ ఆర్ కనెక్టెడ్ బై ది శరీర శరీరి భావం. ఈవన్ దో యూ హ్యావ్ సమ్ కైండ్ ఆఫ్ యూ ఆత్మ ఇన్ సైడ్ హ్యాస్ గాట్ అ పవర్ టు డూ విత్ ది బాడీ, ఓన్లీ అప్ టు ఎ సర్టన్ లిమిట్. లెట్ మీ గివ్ అన్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్. లెట్ సే యూ గో అండ్ రెంట్ ఎ కార్. వెన్ యూ రెంట్ ఎ కార్ ఫ్రమ్ ది హెర్ట్స్ ఆర్ ఏవిస్, సో ఇట్ ఈస్ ఫర్ యూ. యూ కెన్ డూ ఎనీథింగ్ విత్ దట్ వన్ అప్ టు ఎ సర్టన్ ఎక్స్టెంట్. ఓకే, యూ కెన్ డ్రైవ్, యూ కెన్ గో ఫర్ ఆల్ దిస్ పిక్నిక్ అండ్ ఎవ్రీథింగ్, యూ కెన్ ఎంజాయ్, యూ కెన్ బెనిఫిట్ అవుట్ ఆఫ్ దట్. ఆర్ యూ కెన్ గో స్పీడ్ అండ్ యూ కెన్ గెట్ ది టికెట్ ఈవన్ దో ఇట్ ఈస్ ది కార్. యాక్చువల్లీ వాట్ హ్యాపన్స్, ది టికెట్ యూ హ్యావ్ టు పే, ఈవెన్ ది ఓనర్ ఈస్ సంబడీ ఎల్స్ హర్ట్స్. యూ గో ఇంట్ ఇన్ యాక్సిడెంట్, యూ పే ఈవెన్ దో ది ఓనర్ ఈస్ హర్ట్స్, బికాస్ యూ డ్రోవ్ ఇట్ రాంగ్. సేమ్ థింగ్ విత్ ది బాడీ. You understand that one? So, that is the question they are asking. If Bhagavan is present inside you, but how come he is not part of all your karmas? He cannot be. That is what it says. So many times we show that one, you wash your hand after eating sakara pongal. You don't wash your tongue. Okay? So, you never wash your tongue. Similarly, nothing sticks to him. That is called, he said Teflon. Even though they are there, but Bhagavan does not do any of them. The you are a boss up to a certain limit, not too much you can do. Remember where correct the cow is put over here, it can go inside this circle. Huge things you cannot do. They say in the all the upanyasam, what you can do, next person sitting avana kuttalam killalam adikalam pannalam, anything bigger than that you cannot do. You don't have any power. So what the power is given to you, power has been allocated based on your karma, is only a small one. That is why. So, in the sarira shariri bhavam, we have to understand, yes, this is my car, I am driving, I pay the money to Hertz, but you can use only up to a certain extent. If you abuse that one, you pay for it. If you use correctly, you enjoy the benefit. So, if you use the body correctly, You go and do the prabhatti, you go to the mokshaṁ. You go and do all the good things, you get the punyam, you get a better janma. If you do the bad things, it carries to you. So the hearse really wants the car back. That's all they want. And if you do any mistakes, you pay for it. So that is how you understand the sarira shariri bhavam. Even though you are a driver, there is a bigger driver than you. That driver controls you and your car. And he checks you, how old are you, whether you have the license, which state you can do, which car you are using. Everything he checks, then only he gives the car. Because you don't have a car. We cannot create our body. He has to create and give it to you. So we get the loaned car. Our body is a loaned item. Don't you get that one? So that is what the sarira shariri bhavam. You flip it. One side, you are the boss and body is for you. The other one, everything Krishna in this beautifully says, when he says, Kshetrajnam, Cha, Abhi, all the atmas and all the bodies, I am the soul inside. If you understand this one, the next line he says, Kshetra, Kshetrajyo Jnanam, understand who is a Kshetram, Kshetrajnam, Tajnanam, Madamama, Andajnanam, that Jnanam is my religion. Krishna says that one. So, very clearly, Embarumana takes this slogan in Gita Bhashyam and he is explaining a lot on this one, saying that one, our principle, Desikan says in the Pradhana Praditandram. Tandram means some kind of a principle. Praditandram, what we are trying to do, we have something other people don't have. Pradhana Praditandram, there is something exclusively great for you which other people don't have it. Okay? So if you, what can you say? King Midas, you take. He's got something. He touches, everything becomes gold. None of them can do. Something has got exclusive. Similarly, in our religion, Visishtadvaitam, there is no Visishtadvaitam, not even a single word in Sri Bhashya. Given the name later. So, Visishta Advaitam. We are Advaitam, but in a specialized case of Advaitam, we'll go more into Bheda Shruti, Abheda Shruti, Khadaga Shruti, and all of them. We'll go through in the Sri Bhashyam. We'll ask Jagat Karanagan is Bhagavan. Why Jagat Karanam cannot be an Achetanam? Next one. Why Jagat Karanam cannot be Achetanam? So, we'll answer all these things one by one, all of them into that one. So, what we understand is the Jagat Karanagan. And he is the one gives the central soul for everything. He is controlling all of them. He is present everything in all of them. And he never gets any of our karmas attached to him. That is what he understands basically when Krishna says over here. Sarvam samapnoshi tadori sarvaha. Arjuna said that one. Krishna, you are everything. Doesn't mean all the bad thing is Krishna. Only the soul is inside. Outside, if you hit the car, you pay for it. Hertz does not care. Hertz may feel, we have to go and buy another car. So Perumal may feel, I had to give another body for him. Let's see there next time whether he is going to be a good man. That's how it is. So very simple over here. Understand, same thing will come in Gita Bhashyam, same thing will come in Sri Bhashyam, same thing will come in Uddhava Gita. All of them, because that is our principle is based on. We cannot change that one. So you cannot understand body, what it does, without understanding the soul and understanding the super soul. Okay. So coming back here, I don't want to go into the Sri Bhashyam today. So Gajendran here, one more thing. So Samanadi Garanyam, when I say, here also Arjuna says, Sarvam samapnoshi tadosi sarvaha, because you are present in everything, you are everything. Your everything does not mean it's a surubaikyam. There is no surubaikyam. You should understand. Okay? Tayum ponnu onnalum vaayum veyana vera appadi pala. Same thing over here. However close you are, look what happened to Uddhava. Uddhava says, Krishna, I cannot stay without you. I'm like a fish out of the water. That's okay. I go on Air Force One. You take your economy class and come. You come in the cargo class. So your route is different than Perumal's route. Because our two atmas are close, doesn't mean anything. You take your path. They have to take their path. If the two atmas, husband and wife, father and son and mother and daughter are like that, forget about compared to Perumal. So he goes all the way. That is the one thing you have to understand. However close you are to the Bhagavan, you still have to go through your karma. Whatever the prarabdha karma that is given to you, you have to go through that one. There's nothing can be done. That is what he says that way. But on the other hand, we are all little happy. Abhigada prarabdha karma is what? What we have agreed to go through in this janma only from the open box. Anabhigada prarabdha karma, I am not going to go through. And then all the unopened boxes like a sanjida karma, I am not going to do. So we are happy only what is this one. How long it's going to be? 5 years, 10 years, 20 years, how long are you going to live? That's it. So that is one of the great thing. It comes beyond you, something happens, that is the prarabdha karma, abhigada prarabdha karma. Okay, coming back over here, the Gajendra says, Kshetrajnaya, beautifully he says in two ways, compressed everything into, one, the jnanam about the kshetram. That means, you know, you and body are different. Now, Perumal told in the third sloka, what he told, who is a kshetrajnayan? Who is a kshetram? The body. What is a body for Perumal? You and your atma. So, he is the kshetrajnayan. So, now you understand, even though you take the rental car, you are not the boss. That means, swadandra atma abhimanam, brahmam is gone. Within a single word, Gajendra so beautifully put both of them, Sarira Atma Brahmam, Swadandra Atma Brahmam, both of them gone from that one. If you understand clearly, Kshetra Jnaya, what it means, compared with the Krishna's Bhagavad Gita sloka, you know that then both of them are gone. Body, it not belongs to me, Atma is different, and this Atma is not independent, I have to answer to somebody else. Beautifully it says in the two words, because he does not have that much time. Krishna got plenty of time. He's got 700 slokas. Gajendra got only 28 slokas. He has to say, just like Amalanadi Viran Tripanadva said, I have only 10 slokas, 10 pasurams only. Don't ask me, where is the mudra? I don't even have space for to tell for Perumal. So that is why there is no mudra pasuram there. Similarly here, go back into that, how smartly he does. Bhagavan is inside, is the super soul, we told. What is the connection between Shariram and Atma? Shariram and Atma, don't think it has to be like a body and the skin like that. The connection between Shariram and Atma, Desikan gives in the Pradhana Pradidandram based on three things. Supports, controls, owns. Adharam, Niyanta, Seshi. Bhagavan is the supporter, controller and owner. Our atmas are being supported, being controlled and being owned. Adheya niyamya seshatva. So, adharatvam, niyantritvam, seshitvam. Let's go easy one. Support, control, owns. So easily we can say that one. Desikan beautifully explains that one in the Adhikara Sangraham Pasuram in Ragasatrasaram. நிலைதந்த தாரகனாய் நியமிக்கும் இறைவனுமாய் இலது ஒன்று என வகையெல்லாம் தனதெனும் எந்தையுமாய் துளை ஒன்று இளையன நின்ற துழாய் முடியான் உடம்பாய் விலையின்றி நாம் அடியோம் வெடியர் மெய்ப்பொருளே. I don't think nobody can compress all our siddhantam into one pashuram. So beautifully he has done. Nilai tanda taraganai. Taragan, he is the supporter. How he supports? He gives you a state. That is the state. Human being, we are having a state like this one, walking, talking, thinking and doing all of them. Everything on your sarubam, whatever he has given over here, for the atma and the body, everything put together, he is the one holding. Nilai tanda taraganai. Niyamikkum iraivanumai. He is one telling you what you should do. He is managing, he is controlling, he is administrating, he is commanding. That is an Niyamikkum iraivan. You put a word there, is the highest one. Niyamikkum iraivan. இலது ஒன்று எனவகை எல்லாம் தனதெனும் எந்தையுமாய். This is what he took it from the Krishna sir. இலது ஒன், there is nothing in this world which does not belong to him. From that angle he owns everything. He owns everything, he doesn't stop. There is nothing, go into the opposite side. There is nothing that does not belong to him. From that angle, he owns everything. It is like a legal document. You cannot insert anything over there. Thulai ondru ilai, there is nothing equal to him. He is the highest, he is the supreme. Nindra thulai mudiyan, who is that? Thulasi malai podunaan. He is wearing the Tulasi garland. Udambai, for him we are the Sariram. Tulai mudiyan, udambai. Then, we are Seshan. He is the Seshi. We are the slave. He is the master. How that relation is there? Vilai indri naam adiyom. We are not servants being paid by the paycheck. Vilai indri naam adiyom. Because, remember this. What do you have in your Atma? In your Atma, there's only two things are coded. One, Jnanam. The Jnanam that says, me, me, me. In addition, what does it say? I am the slave to him. I am the slave to him. That is embedded, encoded inside, which cannot be changed. Okay? These two. It is not just Jnanam alone. It is the Seshitva Jnanam. Okay? I am the Seshatva Jnanam. He is the Seshi, I am the Seshan. That Seshatva Jnanam, you need that one. That's what it says. Okay. Vilayindri naam adiyom. That is, you cannot give money and get this kind of a relation. It is Shashvatam. It is eternal. How many janmas you take, how many yugas you go through, how many places you cross, which cannot be changed. Because it's a bootstrap code instead. There's nothing you can do. Vediyar meipurule, I am not telling. All the Vediyar, people who do the Adhyayanam of the Vedantam, Upanishads and everything, they finally find out this is the truth. And this is the meaning of the truth. Meipurule. How beautifully Desian has written this Pashuram. When you look at that one, this is the Pradhana Pradhitantram. The Pradhana Pradhitantram, Bhagavan is the supporter, he is the controller, he is the owner. We are being supported, we are being controlled, we are being owned. So he is the master, we are the slave. That relation, because he is the soul, we are the body. That connection is not based on any kind of a trade, any kind of a commerce, any kind of a paid kind of a paycheck. It is Shashvatam. This is what is told, the inner meanings of all the Upanishads. The connection is called Abhridak Siddhi. Undannod Oravel. இங்கே நமக்கு ஒழிக்க ஒழியாது. ஐ கேனாட் டூ தட் ஒன். ஓகே, ஒழிக்க ஒழியாது. ஸோ ஈவன் இஃப் யூ வாண்ட் இட், ஐ கேனாட். நீ என்று நான் இல்லை, நான் என்று நீ இல்லை. ஆழ்வார் சேஸ் ஆல் ஆஃப் தம். தோஸ் ஆர் ஆல் பாயிண்ட்ஸ் டு திஸ் ஒன். ஸோ கஜேந்திரன் காட் ஆல் திஸ் திங்ஸ் இன் இஸ் மைண்ட். தட் இஸ் ஒய் இஸ் இஸ் க்ஷேத்ரஜ்ஞாய நமஸ்துப்யம். பகவானே, ஐ டோன்ட் ஹாவ் தி சரீர ஆத்மா பிரமம், இட்ஸ் கான். சுதந்திர ஆத்மா பிரமம் இஸ் கான். நமக, ஐ எம் சேயிங், ஐ எம் டூயிங் தி சரணாகதி டு யூ. ஹூ இஸ் திஸ் பர்சன்? இஸ் நாட் டோல்ட் யட். ஹூ இஸ் திஸ் பர்சன்? வாட் இஸ் தி தேர்ட் பிரமம்? சரீராத்ம பிரமம், சுதந்திராத்ம பிரமம், அந்நிய தேவத அபரத்வ புத்தி. ஓகே, யூ ஹவ் டு என்கோட் ஆல் ஆஃப் தம் ஹியர். நகசத்திர சாரம் உடைய எசன்ஸ் ஆஃப் தட் ஒன். Even somebody wakes up at 2 o'clock in the morning, you should be able to tell. We don't have to remember anything else. Only very, very few things we have to remember. Sariratma Brahmam, Swadandratma Brahmam, Anyadevada Paratva Buddhi. All the three had to get rid of them. So how he gets rid of the Anyadevada Paratva Buddhi? He is doing Saranagati to him. All other words tell only that person. That's what we are going to see. Atma Moolaya, Moola Prakritaye. Hey, you are for all the Atmas, all the Prakritis. That's it. Nothing. Atma Moolaya. When you look at this, this is not only the Atmas here. The Atmas in Moksham also. You are the origin. You are the boss. You are the root. You are the cause for everything. Prakriti only on this. Because I'm here, I'm telling only about the Prakriti. All of them reports to you. That's what he says. Our Jivatma is a Kshetra Jnaya, I told knower, but it knows only our body. But Bhagavan is a bigger Kshetra Jnaya. He knows all the Atmas, all the bodies put together. That is what he is saying over here. And next one he says, I am referring to you, the two are gone, I am doing Saranagati, but I know you are the final boss. The all other words are going to show is a final boss. Sarva Adhyakshaya, for everything, you are the superintendent, you are the controller, you are the manager. Why? Because, again this is coming from Bhagavad Gita. In Bhagavad Gita, 9th chapter, Krishna says, Maya Adhyakshena Prakriti. I am controlling this Prakriti. Maya is through me. It's mine. That's what he says. Same Adhyakshena. That's what he uses over here. Moola Prakriti he uses there. Sarva Adhyakshena. So he was little more smart. Krishna says, I am doing the Prakriti. Here, Sarva, when he puts a Sarva, he says, Moola Prakriti, Atma Moolaya, for everything, for Atmas and Prakriti, everything you are controlling. So he took the Bhagavad Gita slogan, he added a Sarva in front of that one, so that it includes the Jivatma also. Maya Adhyakshena Prakritihi Suyadesa Characharam Hedu Nanena Kundeya Jat Vivarivardade. That's what he says. Maya Adhyakshena, under my supervision, Prakriti Suyade Saracharam. Prakriti is working to produce all the moving and non-moving stuff. Beautiful. Beautiful. This again, why I am saying is, the first thing we are going to look in the Sibhashyam, the next thing after the four sutras, we are going to look at the Shantogya Upanishad and Sadviddhai. Sadviddhai, Thagaraviddhai, each one of them, all the 32 Vidyas we will go through without knowing all of them. So we don't have to worry about it. We will never do any of them. We should not be doing. But to know all these things, the Sadviddhai Prakaranam, it comes there. How everything is created. Bhagavan thinks, let me manifest into several things. Then it becomes the Tejas. Tejas thought about it. Then it becomes Apaha. Apaha thought about it. Then the earth came. So it does all the Srishti Prakaranam. He is going to say that one. So, Maya Adhyakshena, under my supervision. So, somebody takes that word and says, Agni says, I am manifesting to several things. So, only Agni is doing, sir. Perumal is not doing. No. Maya Adhyakshena, I am the one from the Prakriti. I am doing it, becomes a Tejas. In the Tejas, I am also present. I am doing that one. So, the Antaratma for all of them, he. So, when you say, Agni did this one, Vayu did this one, Rudran did this one, Brahma did this one, you did this one. None of you did. Only he does all of them. Because without me, nothing can move. Bhagavan says, without me, nothing can move. So, everything, later on he says, everything is like a bommalatam, puppet show. I am the one pulling the strings. That is what Krishna said. So, here a Jagat Vibarivartade, Samsara Chakram is revolving because I am doing everything based on the Prakriti. Adhyakshaya, that word, he takes that sloga from that and he puts over here Krishna Gajendra for Sarva Adhyakshaya. Bhagavan, I am saying, I am understanding my body is different from soul and I know you are the super soul. That's not that one. I am doing total surrender to you and who you are. You are the one controlling everything. What else you need? He's going to give all these stacking words to show Bhagavan is the final one who can give you the moksha. Sarva Adhyakshaya. Now let's look. Sarira Sariri Bhavam he brings here. Sarva Adhyakshaya means he's controlling, controls. Atma Moolaya Moola Prakriteye. Origin, root, base, support. Sakshine. How can he be Sakshi for everything unless he is the first one to be there? That means he owns everything. Supports, controls, owns all of the mystery. So if you look at that one, Visishtadvaita Siddhantam, what Krishna told in 13th chapter, with beautiful, simple words, Gajendra is showing over here. Okay? So, Kshetrajnaya, Bhagavan, you are the Atma inside everything. Who are you? Purushaya, you are the highest soul. Everything else is Stri. Because how do we determine is a Purushan? Based on only one property. Independence. Remember that. The reason why Bhagavan is called Purushan is the only one who has got the total independence. Everything else has got dependent. That is why Tirukkallan Swami always says, Purusha alaga mochame gadeyadu. Purusha means what? Somebody who thinks that he is independent, you will never get moksham. The second, what is Newton's laws of motion, Ramari, three rules Desikan gave. Second rule is gone. Swadandratma bhimanam. Okay, that will be gone. That is why he says here. So, Sarvadyakshaya, controller, Atma Moolaya, Moola Pradhyaya, supporting, Sakshine, owns, support control, owns, all of them there, and he gives, Kshetrajnaya, you are the super soul, Purushaya, you are the supreme, independent, Tubhyam, Namo, Namaha. To you, I am doing the Sharanagati. Okay, now, do the Anvayam. Kshetrajnaya, Namastubhyam, Sarvatyakshaya, Sakshine, Purushaya, Atma Moolaya, Moola Pradhyaya, Namaha. That is how we are trying the meaning of this sloka. He put all the words differently. So, implicitly, he is praising the Bhagavan through the Sariraga Sastram. And the Sariraga Sastram is based on Brahma Sutram. Brahma Sutram is Sariraga Sastram. In the Sarira Sastram, what Embarumana are explaining in Sribhashyam is Sarira Atma Bhavam. That is what he is explaining. Visishtadvaita Siddhantam, that is what he is explaining. Every living entity in this world struggling for existence. Not only existence, yeah, better existence what we need. But the only salvation we are going to get, never you will get it in the Leela Vibhuti. Because the Leela Vibhuti is a play world for Bhagavan. You will always will be playing. So, the example what we give usually, the Raja is their king. The king, when he is having all this administrative works, if he gets bored, he goes to the prison. And when he goes to the prison, all the people will be there. So, he takes an apple and give it to the guy who does not have the legs, ask him to take it. He jumps, then he lifts it higher. So, he plays with that one. Ask him to play in the Andhapuram with his queen. He cannot do that. So, Andhapuram is what is that? His own personal place where the queen and everybody stays. That is the Nitya Vibhuti. He cannot play there. Because everybody has got the same jnanam like him. Everybody has got the tejas like him. When he gets out of the seat, there is no way you can distinguish who is Bhagavan, who is Nityan, who is a Muktan. Something like that. Okay? So, that is why he plays here. So, we don't want to be here. That is why even though we try for existence here, it's a super existence here, at some point we understand this deham is a problem for me. So, some people do the yagam and yagyam and everything, I'll become an Indra, I'll become a Brahma. Still you are entrapped. From the samsaram you have to get out. The only way to go to the moksham is through the prabhatti. To do that prabhatti, you have to understand this Sariraga Sastram, or you have to be a baby. Your parents have to do it for you. Okay, so that is what it's saying. So, only one thing finally I want to show over here, if you don't understand clearly what it means, let's take this example. Krishna is telling Arjuna. Now, let's head to the Bhagavad Gita with the Advaitam. Krishna is telling Arjuna. Krishna is thinking Arjuna is different. Bedam. If Krishna has got a Beda Buddhi, Arjuna is different, I am different, then whole Advaitam is gone. There's only one Brahma. So you are everything. So if Arjuna is different, your Abedam is gone. So if Arjuna is himself, Then he discovered his own ignorance. That is why he is teaching himself. So how the Brahma must get the ignorance? Let's say he is teaching to the Maya. He is teaching to the mirror. Anybody who is an intelligent, will he go and teach it to the mirror? This is how he starts the Gita Bhashyam. Okay, Gita Bhashyam starts that one to show Abhedam that is gone. Even the first line itself in Gita Bhashyam, it is gone. Even in the Jagat Karanatvam, when it comes to the Brahma Sutram, it is gone. So what Shankara did is first one started. So with the Upanishad and everything, he tries to explain that one. Later on, we try to refine that one. So you may ask, Swami, Ramanujar come and then only Madhva came. So how he was refuting the Dvaitam also? No. Madhvacharya elaborated. Dvaitam was present even before he came. So Advaitam, Dvaitam was there during the Ramanuja period. But Advaitam was the most prominent one. That is the one he was targeting all the time. That is why ours is a visit to Advaitam. At that time, you know Dvaitam, Advaitam. So when you say Abheda Shruti and Bheda Shruti, joining is a Khadaka Shruti he was trying to tell. So that is what the Gita Bhashyam, maybe in one of the 10 minutes, I will take the source code, exactly what Ramanuja says, and the source code and be explained. Because Gita Bhashyam, we can tell some of them. Sri Bhashyam, we have to be a little more careful what we tell in all of them. So finally, in this sloka, when you look at that one, so beautifully this Gajendran says, Kshetrajnaya, that word itself will carry everything what we wanted to say. Kshetrajnaya, Atma Moolaya, Moola Prakritiye. Remember Moola Prakriti. We are interpreting this one based on Visitta Advaitam. And when we go to the Sri Bhashyam, when we are trying to explain, Jagat Karanatvam, who created, who sustains, who destroys all of them, it can be Prakriti itself, Achetanam. Shankhya says that one, Nirishwara Tattvam. For the Nirishwara Tattvam, Moola Prakriti, that is what they call. The Prakriti is a Moola Prakriti, is a starting point. So we don't need anything. So they give a beautiful example, all of them. There is no person to be involved. You go for a dance. In the dance, the girl is doing the dance. Okay? When the girl is doing the dance, she is doing all of them. You are watching. You are the bhakta. What you are doing? You are not doing anything, but you are just enjoying. That's why I say, no. Bhoktrutvam and kartrutvam, it has to be in the single place. It cannot be two different kinds of things. So, kartrutvam dance arrava and bhoktrutvam you are enjoying. So, it's two different, you can say, that is example. When all these people, when they give examples, they try to give example that is convenient for them. So, they try to hide other things. So the answer for that one, Emperor Manar gives, don't say that there is no Kartrutvam for him. He is having a bhogyam. Is he closing his eyes? He has to be present in the stage. What happens if he sits at home? So he has to move his body, he has to come there, he has to open his eyes, he cannot be sleeping. That is the Kartrutvam he does. That is the bhogyatvam he has got. So what she is doing Kartrutvam? She is dancing. What is the bhogyatvam? She gets money and she leaves. That is the bhogyatvam. So beautifully he explains that one. She does not. What is the bhogyam for her? She gets money to dance. That's all it is. She doesn't care about you, whether you enjoy or not. So kartrutvam and bhoktrutvam has to be in the single place. Because Prakriti cannot have this kind of a bhoktrutvam. Because it's a jadam. That is why it cannot be a kartrutvam. We'll see that next week. And the Sri Bhashyam class. So, but anyhow, I just want to show all of them. When you see the Moola Prakriti, go back and read some other Advaitam book or Dvaitam book, you get confused. They call it as a Moola Prakriti. We separate it, Prakriti and Moolam. So, Prakriti is the base for that one. Only two things you see, Prakriti and then Atmas. What else you see in the Leela Vibhuti? Time, that's a different one, he is controlling. Other than that, there's nothing else. So Bhagavan is the Moolam for that. That is why we shrink these two things. Prakriti Moolam, Atma Moolam. So we call it Adi Moolame. That is why we call, even though there is not a single word Adi Moolame in this sloka here. Okay. So we'll stop at this point. And in the next class again, each sloka I never thought when we started Gajendra Moksham, each one is so super sloka what Gajendra has written. Same thing, even Uddhava Gita, when you look at that one, each of the slokas, all the Upanishad Tattvams, all the Visishtadvaita Siddhantam, what you study. So if you know a little bit of Ragasyatra Saram, it gives a big hand in all these things to understand. Okay, so we'll stop here. Kavidharke Gasimmaya Kalyana Gunasalini, Simare Venkadesaya Vedanta Gurave Namaha, Simare Nihamanta Mahadeshikaya Namaha.